begin, we are going to do something called NASSCOM Mr. Intelligent 2013 or Miss Intelligent 2013. All you need to do is kindly take out your cell phones, please. Take out your cell phones. Put it on silent mode. That's not the contest though. Okay. This is all about your hand and eye coordination. Okay. When I say telephone, all your cell phones go to the receiver's end, please. All of you, telephone to receiver's end. When I say cradle, it goes down. All right? Telephone. Cradle. Telephone. Telephone. Yes. I will try and dodge you. You should not be dodged. Let's see who is the most concentrating person here. Here we go. Telephone. Cradle. Telephone. Cradle. Cradle. Very good. Those of you who are honestly still a part of this, kindly stand up, please. Kindly stand up. In your positions. Perfect. Thank you. In your positions, one twist in the tail, instead of telephone cradle, we will have dil and dimag. When I say dil, point your finger to your heart, dimag to your brain. Okay? Dil. Dimag. Dil. Dimag. Dimag. Sit down, sir. Yes. Well done. थिंकिंग मेरा दिल कहाँ गया, मेरा भेजा कहाँ है. राइट, दिल, दिमाग. यू नीड टू लुक एट मी. कम ऑन, आई एम सो प्रिटी. इफ यू डू नॉट लुक एट मी, हाउ विल आई डॉज यू. ओके, दिल, दिमाग, दिल, दिल. राइट, क्विकली बैक टू टेलीफोन क्रेडल. टेलीफोन क्रेडल. टेलीफोन. टेलीफोन. व्हाट हैपेंड, यू गॉट अ मिस्ड कॉल. राइट, last session to go. Okay, and for this one, interchange, just like NASSCOM, every year it only gets bigger and better. Now this is dil and this is dimag. Interchange. Okay, dil, dimag, dil. But just before that, let me tell you, the winner gets a free trip to Malaysia, the loser gets to go to Malishwaram. Okay, dil, dimag, dil, dil. Wonderful. Round of applause to the gentleman here and the lady there. Huge round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for Mr. and Miss NASSCOM Intelligent 2013. Congratulations, very well done. With that, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to progress to the next set of the event. I'd like to invite Mr. M.R. Rangaswamy to please come forward and take this event.
Okay, thank you. Okay, good afternoon. We're going to get going. We've got several great speakers, and to kick off this afternoon, before we do that, let's look at what's happened this morning. Okay, the top four sessions got 100% approval scores. The main hall, which is also the keynotes, got 93% in terms of your feedback, 672 votes. So keep this going. At the end of every session, again, in your agenda, you'll see two numbers to leave missed calls, so if you like them, dial the first. If you don't, dial the second. If you're agnostic, don't do anything and fall asleep. Okay, great. Do we have a second slide here? Or is that it? Okay. These are the winners of the competition from this morning. Your cell phones ending in the following, so take a quick look. If you go to the Shimmer Lounge, you can collect your prize. 2236-4000-9760-0503-6150. Okay, so keep it going. We got more prizes coming. Okay, to kick off this afternoon, we've got cars. And I had the privilege of driving one of these cars a couple of years ago. It was a pretty cool thing in Bangalore to drive an electric car. And who better to talk about how cars are connected with IT? The founder of Riva, Chetan Maini, please. Please welcome Chetan.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here today. I looked at the scores and I said, wow, we've got a tough afternoon to keep up with that stuff. Could I get the projection on, please? So I thought I'd start with my story of coming here and my journey, which is in an electric car that I took. Started off by saying, hey, it's too hot. Why don't I cool my car down? It was 28 degrees when I started off. You press a button, your smartphone, you connect to it, and you can turn it on. I wanted to make sure that I could get here. I didn't realize that coming from Bomsandra, past Electronic City, this is the other side of the world on this area in Bangalore. And you can map your distance away, check in real time how much range you have, and optimize your route to look at it. So simple connectivity can really make a difference in terms of your comfort level and range anxieties that you may have available today. We can today do a lot more than just this area. We're talking about connectivity that could look at completely looking at diagnostics very differently. A car that can communicate with you. So if something goes wrong at 3 in the morning and you have a problem with your charging system, we can actually talk to the service center, tell you what's wrong. And today 70% of the problems we can find, we can do even before our customers talk to us. So try to look at consumer experiences and customer satisfaction very differently. It's also about changing in the entire ecosystem of looking at simple features like locking, unlocking of your cars, of how far you can go, or a host of applications to see where charge ports could be, or even future applications where you can see how you can press a button and charge your car, which means when time of day metering is available, you can actually sense that at 3 in the morning I'm going to start charging and save energy. So there's a connectivity, which is an obvious one, across to your smartphone. There's a second level of connectivity that starts to take into the intelligence that you have around. So I'm going to go through one of these features on this area, which we call Revive. So if you ever fall low on range, through your smartphone or through a button in the car, you press a button, and within around 30 seconds, you'll get around 8 to 10 kilometers of reserve energy. So the fact that you're connected, the way you drive or I drive, a car that's 1 year old or 5 years old, a car that would be in Bangalore or in London, and different temperature conditions, would be very different. But if in real time I knew how you drove your car, and I had data of how you've used your car, then I'm very intelligent about projecting a sophisticated algorithm for you at that point to enable you to get an extra distance to get home. Now, when I said current and future opportunities, everything I've talked to you about today is available in Bangalore in a showroom, designed in Bangalore, and I think therefore the connected car is actually a reality as we look at it. But there's a lot more you can look at connected cars. I see connected cars in areas of looking at how you would use it within the inside space and the energy outside. So to start off with, we spend 8 to 10 hours at home, probably the same time at work, hopefully less. But the third most important space has been the car. So this third space needs to be more entertaining for us or more productive for us. And this is the next shift, be it the Internet of Things, be it how you connect with being more productive on this area, be it a sense of infotainment systems, taking this to the next level is going to be the next big shift as you see on the automobile inside the car. But then what about taking the next step? What about one car to another car? So the vehicle-to-vehicle interactions and vehicle-to-the infrastructure interactions are the next two areas to look at. Now this changes it from just being entertaining or productive to start to look at much bigger pictures. It starts to look at how I can be much more safer. For example, if I can predict what the other car is doing in real time and that communicates it back to me, maybe I can trigger a seatbelt pretension or a host of other things much faster and make your experience much better. Similarly, in infrastructure, if I'm linked up with a system in Bangalore, I think half our traffic woes will go away and we'll probably flow much quicker. I think the power here is going to be when more and more gets added, because it starts to grow exponentially when you connect a lot more of the system together and the intelligence that you can look at making this happen. The third area starts to look at the fact of getting away from the car to see what's going to be the experience around connectivity. Finally, if I want to get from point A to point B in a city, I want my experience to be right. I want a virtual ownership where maybe my first mile is using an electric car getting to a metro station, and then I use a metro system and my last kilometers again that way, and I get much faster, I use much less energy, and I predicted the way I want to do. So virtual ownership of products and mobility as a solution, integrating this will form a different level of connectivity as we think about it. take a step further. Imagine the same solution. You had driverless cars, and actually the car came to your house. Instead of driving on freeways across the country, you use the first mile, last mile on the smart way, and then connect to the systems and solutions that you have. You bring about a connectivity in an ecosystem of mobility solutions. Moving from the solutions, what about the energy space? So connectivity, we always think, is mobile devices. But there's also, as you look at future cars and electric cars, the connectivity is around the energy system. So today, Delhi, for example, has 200,000 CNG cars. If half of them were electric, 100,000 of them, and you plug them into the grid at the same time, these cars could give you approximately 10 kilowatts of energy each, maybe 100 megawatts of power. Now, as a city, you either have an option of putting new transformers and a host of other devices, or you could buy power from these vehicles when there was a big challenge, and then the cars buy back power at 3 in the morning to look at it. So it's about connecting energy as well as your mobile platform together to start looking at how you see the infrastructure of smart grid systems and bringing that into automobiles in a big way. Moving this to the home, you get another level of energy and efficiency with car connectivity. So, to give you an idea, a 3 meter by 3 meter panel can give you free energy for life, 15,000 kilometers a year for an electric car. Now, today's, last 2 weeks ago, Karnataka government announced that talked about feed-in tariffs. So now you've got a smart home, you can actually use it today, you can actually buy these solutions right now, use the energy when you need it into your grid, and then when you come back at night, charge back, and therefore you have a much more efficient system on this area. You have a car-to-home solution where your car can actually use to power your home back, and with communication linked to it, you can just say, hey, I want to leave at 8 in the morning and I want to make sure I have X amount of energy, and it manages my entire energy. With smart homes coming in and smart cars coming in, you're talking of a host of connectivity, be it from air conditioning systems, security systems, or an energy management system that connects together as you bring these smart devices coming in here. Looking at them, what you're seeing is a change in how we perceive connectivity. I think we're all aware that you've got your mobile device and you've got a computer, and then coming together has changed what we've looked at. You've just added a third part of the picture related to how you see the mobility aspect. And I think this enables a completely different set of businesses that come through and applications that you can look at here. And for the group that's here, that's very focused on the IT front, looking at new opportunities, to me, I think this is a really vast open space of how we would see things come together. It's about applications that could come on the third space of infotainment and looking at how we see things completely change on that area. It's looking at completely looking at safety systems. It's looking at solutions around the grid and connectivity. It's looking at mobility solutions across platforms within other transportation materials. It's looking at emergency services. And so the list would go on in terms of what I think is available and what you can do as you look at this entire connectivity space. And for a lot of you guys here who are looking at new ideas, I think this is a great space to be in, because the power of this becomes so much more as more connections come into it. And I think that's what happens. And probably even as car makers, we don't know what the possibilities are, because tomorrow you may take the G sensor of a car and three other sensor data and combine it together and create an application that we're completely clueless on that could make a difference in people's lives. So I think it's about the way you see these things come together is going to be huge. To me, an important part of all of this is actually going to be about the experience. I think this is what makes a difference when we look at how people perceive it. And it's about ideas and insights and technology coming together to create that form of an experience on this area. And to give you an example, I want to go back to the technology part I talked to you earlier, where at a touch of a button, you can get emergency range. There's actually a large insight into this. We had a customer who came to our showroom, and he said, listen, I want to buy this car, but I'm concerned about the range. We said, oh, don't worry, it has a number that tells you how far you can go. It has lights that come on, and it is a complete solution that has it. What we fail to recognize is what he was trying to say is, I'm buying this for my wife, and she's going to have my four-year-old daughter drop to school. And what if this stops in the middle of the road, like my mobile did last night, or my laptop did? So it is a shift of anxiety, it was a shift of concern of how people thought of adoption technology. So the idea was, okay, for marketing, how do you zap energy in? Well, the solution then finally came as, why don't we connect the cars, and why don't we real-time monitor them, and look at the amount of energy you have in there, and then remotely activate that, but then everyone used a different piece. So connectivity and the software and the servers and everything became a technology to implement an insight which is addressing a consumer need. And I think that it's more than just software. And I think where we need to be moving into is understanding such consumer insights in the space of connectivity. And I think when we get these, the business opportunities around that are going to be tremendous when we take this through. I did want to have a shorter session and keep it more open and interactive. So I'm going to stop at this point and open it up for question and answers.
Job, Chetan. First person to ask a question gets a free Riva. So, oh, there. Okay, he's got it. Please, speak up. So, question is, when will we see driverless cars in Bangalore on these nice roads?
That is a perfect comment. Yeah. We already had driverless cars. At least I think we did. We don't follow lanes. Or any sensor systems. I think that the challenge is not going to be technology. The challenge is going to be society. So I think driverless cars are reality in 5 years from today. But if someone hits a five-year-old kid in a regular car, you may manage things. Imagine a driverless car hitting a five-year-old kid. So are we in society geared to make changes on this area? So I think that's going to be the first, that'll be a bigger question that's going to come in on this area. And I think that India is going to need a different solution for driverless cars. While US and Europe looks at solutions around the fact that, how do I go on a highway across town? Wouldn't you love that first mile or last mile being driverless because you don't get parking? And so you say, okay, I'm just going to drop myself outside here and my car goes and parks itself, and when I want it comes back. So maybe the solutions for India and a lot of other places for driverless would be different. And I think there are opportunities, therefore, of making much simpler ones. And maybe those could be areas of good connectivity.
Who had the question? Okay.
Are the electronic platform on the in the car ready to expose the APIs and so on? I mean, is it really ready? Are you thinking about that way?
So this current system, you have an app which is on your phone, so it's available on a Windows or an Android or a BlackBerry or an iPhone. The car is a Windows CE based system. So far, it's limited on the thing. We've been working on security, but I think in less than a year, we will have an available option with APIs available to developers to start working on it. We need to figure out the security part, really. So we're testing that. So I would love to open that up, because I think we've got so much talent here that this would really start to change how you look at connectivity. So hopefully the next conference will have a platform with a lot of you all having designed into it.
Great. Next question over there. Yeah. Oh, here. Okay.
Hi.
Yeah.
Hi, my name is Niranjan. Thank you very much for the presentation. Enjoyed it very much. Lots of ideas. How is Mahindra Reva working with startups which are working on solving some of these problems?
So the app you saw was built by a startup in Bangalore and done right here. So I think we're working a lot. We have cars today which are being used in the first self-drive application with a company called Zoom in Bangalore, again a startup. So yes, we've been trying to work with them. I think some great ideas, and we're looking forward to looking at ways of integrating that.
Okay, one last question, please.
Yeah, should I actually be worried that other people are driving my driverless car? I mean, you know, people with much more technical ability than myself. Should I be actually worried about that, or is there is that something not even a problem that I should bother about?
Do you worry when you fly a plane who gets you from point to point? The plane does most of the work and allows you to land when it's foggy and stuff. So I think that intelligence is so much higher today. And I think it's going to be a worry initially. I don't know if you've ever driven one of these. It scares the hell out of you because you sit there and something is turning or braking before you. So yes, it's going to be a natural reaction to come in there. You know, but my wife's a backseat driver and I'm too also, so I think it's part of that process. But, yeah.
Let me clarify. Super.
Okay, one last question.
Yeah.
Pricing on the car and range?
Retails from around 7 lakhs in Bangalore, around 100 kilometers range.
Thank you, Chetan.
Right.
Really
Thanks.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thanks. And we hope to have you next year announcing an open platform.
Great.
Thank you. Okay, so please use the missed call numbers in your agenda book for Chetan. I think you did a fabulous job, and you may win a Riva one day.